Welcome to all of you. Today we will discuss about the amino acids and polypeptide topic. Amino acids, what is meant by amino acids? An amino acids is a bifunctional organic molecule that contain both a carboxyl group, that is the COOH group, as well as an amino group, that is called the NH2 group. Amino acids derived from the protein have the amino group on the alpha carbon, that is the carbon atom next to the carboxylic group. Then amino acids, they are molecules containing an amino group, a carboxylic acid group, and side chain that is specific to each amino acids. The key element of amino acids are the carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. Amino acids are the basic structural building unit of protein and other biomolecules. They are also utilized as an energy source. Amino acids also are the building blocks of proteins. There are 300 amino acids that occur in nature. But out of 300 amino acids, among these only 22 amino acids are known amino acids, and they are also called the standard amino acids that commonly occur in the proteins. So general structures of amino acid, they are shown in the slide. One structure is draw R, then NH2 and COOH, and one is the carbon. So COOH, that is the carboxylic group, NH2, that is the amino group, carboxylic group, that is the acidic group, and NH2, that is amino group. So this group is called basic group, and they are seen in the R. So R is the organic substituent. So these three groups are attached to the same carbon atom, so they are called the alpha carbon. Then what are the general formula? They are seen in the slide. Then the amino acids differ in the nature of R group attached to alpha carbon atom. The nature of R group determine the properties of protein. Means properties of protein, they are totally depend upon the R radicals or R group. So what are the physical properties of amino acid? So first one physical property is amino acids are crystalline in nature, also colorless substance. Then second one, they may be tasteless like tyrosine, or sweet like a glycine, or can be bitter like arginine. Then third, amino acids are polar substance which are soluble in polar solvent like water and ethanol. And last one, all amino acids possess asymmetric carbon atom except glycine, where it is a symmetry. So these are the physical properties of amino acid. Then next one, general classification of amino acid. Amino acid having a two class. First one is the standard amino acids, and second one is the non-standard amino acid. So first one, standard amino acids. Amino acids join together to form short polymer chain called peptides, or longer chain called their polypeptides, and also they are called the proteins. These polymers are linear and unbranched, with each amino acid within the chain attached to two neighboring amino acids. 22 amino acids are naturally incorporated into polypeptides and are called proteogenic or natural amino acids. Of these, 20 are encoded by the universal genetic code. The remaining two are incorporated into protein by unique synthetic mechanisms. Then second one important class, non-standard amino acids. Aside from the 22 standard amino acids, there are many other amino acids that called the non-proteogenic or non-standard amino acids. They are either not found in protein, for example keratin and GABA, or are not produced directly. Non-standard amino acids that are found in protein are formed by post-translation modification, which is modification after translation during protein synthesis. These modifications are often essential for the functions or regulations of protein. For example, the carboxylation of glutamate allows for better binding of calcium cations. Some non-standard amino acids are not found in proteins. Examples included लैथियोनाइन, 2 अमीनो आइसोब्यूटरिक एसिड, डिहाइड्रो अलेलाइन एंड द न्यूट्रो ट्रांसमीटर गैमा अमीनो ब्यूटरिक एसिड। नॉन स्टैंडर्ड अमीनो एसिड ऑफन ऑकर इंटरमीडिएट इन द मेटाबोलिक पाथवेज, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मेटाबोलिक पाथवेज। सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल लाइक ग्लाइकोलिसिस, ग्लाइकोनियोजेनेसिस, देन TCS साइकिल। सो दीज आर द मेटाबोलिक पाथवेज, और दिस मेटाबोलिक पाथवेज नॉन स्टैंडर्ड अमीनो एसिड्स एज अ इंटरमीडिएट प्रोडक्ट। फॉर द स्टैंडर्ड अमीनो एसिड्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल और ओरिएंथाइन एंड सिट्रुलाइन ऑकर इन द यूरिया साइकिल। देन नेक्स्ट वन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ अमीनो एसिड। अमीनो एसिड आर क्लासिफाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर। दे हैव क्लासिफाइड इन टू 8 क्लास। यू नो दैट 22 अमीनो एसिड्स आउट ऑफ 300 दे आर अ नोन अमीनो एसिड। सो दिस 22 अमीनो एसिड्स आर, आउट ऑफ 22 अमीनो एसिड्स 20 अमीनो एसिड्स आर नोन एंड दे आर हेल्प टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्रोटीन। दे आर क्लासिफाइड इन टू 8 क्लास। फर्स्ट वन इज द एलिफैटिक अमीनो एसिड, सेकेंड वन इज द हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप कंटेनिंग अमीनो एसिड्स, थर्ड वन इज द सल्फर कंटेनिंग अमीनो एसिड, फोर्थ वन इज द एसिडिक अमीनो एसिड्स एंड देयर अमाइड्स, देन फिफ्थ वन इज द बेसिक अमीनो एसिड्स, सिक्स्थ वन इज द एरोमेटिक अमीनो एसिड्स, सेवन्थ वन इज द इमिनो अमीनो एसिड्स एंड एट वन क्लास इज द अमीनो एसिड अमाइड। वन बाय वन वी विल डिस्कस। सो फर्स्ट वन एलिफैटिक अमीनो एसिड, also this aliphatic amino acid also called the simple amino acid. Why they are called aliphatic and why they are called simple amino acid? Because no any functional group, they are attached to the side of chain. This amino acid called the aliphatic amino acid, also they are called the simple amino acid. These are the monocarboxylic acid. This group consists most simple amino acid. So example of simple amino acid or also their aliphatic amino acid, first one is the glycine, then alanine, valine, leucine and isoleucine. These are the aliphatic amino acids. Then first one simple amino acid is the glycine. Small simple amino acid R group is hydrogen. It is a non-essential amino acid. Glycine is allostatic inhibitor of glutathione synthesis. So they are shown in the structure. One is the carboxylic group, they are highlighted in the yellow color, and second one is the NH2 group, they are highlighted in the white color. That is the optically inactive, only hydrogen atom is attached to the side of chain. So they are called the simple amino acid and they are also non-essential amino acid, glycine. Then second one is the alanine. It is a non-essential amino acid. Alanine is allostatic inhibitor of glutathione synthesis. So alanine having two types, one is the D-alanine and second one is the B-alanine. So in case of D-alanine, it is the component of bacterial cell wall, and B-alanine amino acid they are found in pantothenic acid. So they are shown in the structure. One is the highlighted in the COOH group, they are highlighted in the yellow color, and NH2 group they are highlighted in the white color. Hydrogen also they are attached to the same carbon atom, but in case of R group they are change only side of chain, they are attached only the CH3 group, so they are called the alanine. Then valine, it is also essential amino acids. It has an aliphatic hydrophobic isopropyl, they are having three carbons side of chain. So this valine is the branched chain amino acid. So they are attached to this side of chain in this structure. They are highlighted in the pink color, CH, CH3, CH3. These are the isopropyl group. They are having a three carbon atom. They are attached to the side of chain. So that is the structure of valine, or they are also branched chain structure. Then leucine. Leucine, it is an essential amino acid. It has an aliphatic hydrophobic isopropyl. They are having a four carbon atom in the side of chain. They are similar as per the valine, but difference between this leucine and valine, valine having a three carbon on the side of chain. In case of leucine, they are having a four carbon atom on a side of chain. So they are also seen in this structure. They are highlighted in the pink color. There are CH2, CH, CH3, CH3. So they are also branched chain structure of leucine. Then isoleucine, it is an essential amino acid. It has an aliphatic hydrophobic isopropyl 4 carbon side of chain, similar as per the leucine. Only 4 carbon atoms, they are attached to the side of chain. They are highlighted in the pink color, CH, CH3, CH2, CH3. So they are also branched chain. Then hydroxyl group containing amino acid means these hydroxyl amino acids, they are called hydroxyl? Because hydroxyl group, they are attached to the side of chain. These amino acid called the hydroxyl amino acid. For example, like serine, threonine and tyrosine. These are the examples of hydroxyl amino acid. First one is the serine. It is a non-essential amino acid. It is an alcohol group. Is a site for phosphorylation of many proteins seen in the structure. One COOH group, one is the amino group, that is the NH2 group. But in case of this structure, one H hydrogen group from carboxylic group, they are transferring into the amino group. Amino group, already two hydrogen atom is present, but extra one hydrogen atom is added. They are from carboxylic group. And in case of side of chain, CH2OH group is attached. OH group, that is the hydroxyl group, they are attached to the side of chain. So this amino acid is the hydroxyl amino acid. They are called the serine. Then next one, threonine. It is a essential amino acid. Threonine alcohol side group is a target for phosphorylation of protein. Threonine also having their CHOH and CH3 group. They are highlighted in the pink color. They are attached to the side of chain. Then they are from the threonine. They are also hydroxyl structure. Why they are called hydroxyl? Because one hydroxyl group is attached to the side of chain in case of threonine. Then next, third one is the sulfur containing amino acids. So why they are called the sulfur containing amino acid? Because one sulfur atom or a sulfur group is attached to the side of chain. So they are called the sulfur containing amino acid. For example, is the cysteine, or second one is the methionine. In case of cysteine, it is a non-essential amino acid. Cysteine, another important sulfur containing amino acid, it is formed by the condensation of two molecules of cysteine. So cysteine, they are show in the structure, the side of chain, one sulfur atom is attached to this chain, side of chain, seen in the pink. They are denoted in the, highlighted in the pink color. CH2SH group is attached to the side of chain. So this bonding is sulfhydryl bonding, and also this structure is called as cysteine. Then second one important example in sulfur containing amino acid, that is the methionine. It is an essential amino acid, and genetic code, methionine is coded by codon AUG. This codon is called start codon. Methionine is the first amino acid used to build a protein chain. So this thioether group is attached to this side of chain, that is CH2, CH2, SCH3. These are denoted in pink color or highlighted in the pink color in the this structure. So that is the methionine. Then fourth one important type or classification of amino acid, that is the acidic amino acid and their amides. So aspartic acid, asparagine, glutamic acid and glutamine. So in case of, these are the examples of acidic amino acid. Why they are called acidic amino acid? Because already you know that this amino acid having one acidic group is present. So another one acidic group is attached to this same carbon atom. So these amino acid called the acidic amino acids. So aspartic acid, it is an essential amino acid. Aspartic, it is capable for forming ionic bond and involving in chemical reaction. So beta carboxyl means another one carbon atom is attached to this first carbon atom, that is the alpha carbon, and second is the beta carbon. They are denoted in the structure. So that is the structure of aspartic acid. Another one, already one carboxylic is group is attached to the alpha carbon. So another one COH group is attached to the second number carbon atom, so they are called the beta carbon. So there is a beta carboxyl, so that is the structure of aspartic acid. Then glutamic acid, it is an non-essential amino acids. Vitamin K2 carboxylate glutamate residue in a certain proteins to give carboxylic glutamate. This modification allow protein to bind calcium, an essential event in a blood clotting cascade. So they are showing in this structure. First one carbon atom, they are attached to the one carboxylic group, and third one carbon atom is attached to another one carboxylic group. So this carbon is called as the gamma carbon, because already in case of aspartic acid, the second number of carbon, their second number of carboxylic group is attached to the second number of carbon. So this carbon is the beta carbon. So third number of carbon attached to the another one carboxylic group, so this carbon is called as a gamma carbon, or this structure is the gamma carboxyl structure, or they are called the glutamic acid. So glutamic acid and aspartic acid, that is the example of acidic amino acid. Then asparagine and glutamine, these are the examples of amino acid amide. So it is a non-essential amino acid, asparagine. They are shown in the structure. One amide group is attached to the side of chain. Already one amide group, amino group is attached to the carbon atom, and another one amide group is attached to the side of chain. So this structure is called as asparagine, or they are a non-essential amino acid. Glutamine, it is also non-essential amino acid. It is very important component in transmission of reaction. So they are shown in the structure. Another one amide group, that is the NH2 group, CONH2 group, they are attached to the side of chain. So that is the amide group. They are attached to the side of chain. They are shown in the structure. So that is called the glutamine. So these aspartine and glutamine, these are the examples of amino acid amide. What are the relation between acidic amino acid and amides, amino acid amide? Because in case of this one amino group is replaced by amide group in case of acidic amino acid. So there are relation between to each other, amino acid amide and acidic amino acid. So basic amino acid, fifth one example, why they are called basic amino acid. Another one basic group, that is NH2 group, is attached to the side of chain. So these amino acid called the basic amino acid. They having example lysine, arginine and histidine. So lysine, it is an essential amino acid. These are the strongly polar. So one amide group is attached to the side of chain, that is amino group, NH2 group, it are attached to the side of chain. They are shown in the structure, they are highlighted in the pink color. Then arginine, it is an semi essential amino acid. It contains glutenoid group and is monocarboxylic acid. It is an intermediate in urea cycle and it precursor for nitric oxide. The glutidinium, they are shown in this structure. They are highlighted in the pink color. They are attached to the side of chain in this structure. Then histidine, it is an semi-essential amino acid. It contains imidazole ring, they are shown in this structure. They are attached to the side of chain. So this structure is called as a histidine or imidazole ring. They are present NH2 group, NH2, that is the amino group or basic group. There are also already one basic group is present into the same structure. Another one basic group is attached to the side of chain. So this structure is the histidine, on this amino acid called the basic amino acid. Then sixth one, aromatic amino acids. So in this aromatic amino acid, there one benzene ring or phenol ring, they are attached to the side of chain. So this structure or this amino acid called the aromatic amino acids. Example is the phenylalanine, tryosine, tryptophan. So phenylalanine, it is the essential amino acid. It contains benzene ring attached to the side of chain. They are shown in the structure. They are highlighted in the pink color. The one benzene ring is attached to the side of chain. So that is the structure of phenylalanine. Then tryosine, it is a non-essential amino acid. The hydroxyl group of tryosine impart slightly polarity to the side of chain and is a site for phosphorylation in a protein. There are also one benzene ring and one hydroxyl group that are attached to the side of chain. In case of tryosine, they are shown in the structure. They are highlighted in the pink color. Then tryptophan, it is essential amino acid. It contains indole ring. This one indole ring is attached to the side of chain. They are highlighted in the pink color. Already one benzene ring and another one benzene ring is attached to this same ring. Then they are formed the indole ring, and this indole ring is attached to the side of chain in the amino acid. So this amino acid called the tryptophan, or they are called the aromatic amino acid. Then last seventh one is the immunoamino acid. So this immunoamino acid also called the heterocyclic amino acid. The proline containing pyrrolidine ring is a unique amino acid. It is an immuno group, that is the double bond NH. Therefore proline is a alpha amino acid. They are shown in the structure. That is the amino acid, or they are called the heterocyclic amino acid. Then amino acid amide, these are the derivatives of acidic amino acid, is in which one of the carboxylic group has been transferred into an amide group, that is a CONH2 group. Example is the asparagine and glutamine. They are all already discussed in the last part. So one structure is the asparagine and second one structure is the glutamine. So thank you so much.